Amen. Because God has an answer to everything.
Amen.
Go with me to 1 Samuel, the 16th chapter of 1 Samuel. 1 Samuel, the 16th chapter. We're going to read 3 verses, 17, 18, and 19. 1 Samuel chapter 16, verses 17, 18, and 19. When you have it, and ask that you rest to your feet in reverence, amen, unto the Lord. Amen. And Saul said unto his servants, provide me now a man that can play well and bring him to me. Then answered one of the servants and said, behold, I have seen a son of Jesse the Bethlehemite, that is cunning and plain, and a mighty violent man, and a man of war, and prudent in matters, and a comely person, and the Lord is with him. Wherefore Saul sent a messenger unto Jesse and said, send me David thy son, which is with the sheep. I want to stop right there. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord God, I pray thee, Father, that you will remove L.D. Parker now. Still in your Holy Spirit right now, Father, and put your words in my mouth. In the name of Jesus, we pray. Amen. And Saul said unto his servants, provide me now a man that can play well and bring him to me.
Yes, yes.
And then answers one of the servants and said, behold, I have seen a son of Jesse the Bethlehemite, and that is cunning in play and a mighty valiant man, and a man of war and prudent in matters, and a comely person, and the Lord is with him.
Yes.
Wherefore Saul sent messengers unto Jesse and said, send me David, thy son, which is with the sheep.
Uh-huh.
I want to speak on the subject this morning. Somebody ought to see God in you.
Uh-huh. Yep.
Somebody ought to see Jesus in you. Somebody to see the Holy Spirit in you, amen, that they can recognize, amen, and tell somebody else about you. Come on, somebody, you ought to put your hands together for the Lord in this house. I hear, amen, in this particular scripture. Amen, amen, amen. Saul, amen, being the king, had a compassion, amen, to hear some praise music. Come on, somebody. Saul, amen, in his spirit, amen, needed an upliftment. Amen. Saul, amen, in his spirit, amen, needed somebody, amen, not just anybody. Look at your neighbor and say, neighbor, you can't just call on anybody. Come on, somebody. Amen. Y'all gonna pray with me in here. You cannot just call on anybody. So Saul, amen, began, amen, to ask of his servants, have you heard? Have you seen? Amen. Do you know of anybody that can play well? Anybody, amen, that has the Holy Spirit in them. Do you know anybody, amen, that is anointed, amen, and not about self, that is not playing church, amen, but is church? Do you know anybody, amen, that is on fire for the Lord in the house of God and not on fire for the devil outside of the church? Do you know anybody? Saul, amen, he went to his servants and said, servants, do you know anybody? My God, Jesus is asking that same question right now. For he says, I'm looking for someone to serve me. I'm looking, amen, for someone to worship me. I'm looking for someone to give me the praise, amen, in spirit and in truth. My God, I got to pray in church with me this morning. Saul, amen, sent out his messengers. He said, hey, do you know anybody? Yeah, it's a good thing, amen. Because one of his servants said, yes, sir. King Saul, there is a person. My God. It's a good thing, amen, when somebody is inquiring. Amen. And say, well, I need somebody, amen, that is filled with the Holy Ghost.
Yes, yes.
I need somebody, amen, that will preach the word of God, not in self, amen, but they will preach the word of God in spirit and in truth, amen. And then they can move, amen, the spirit of man, woman, boy, and girl. I don't need nobody, amen, that is all about themselves. No. I need somebody that is going to be able to play in the anointing.
Yes.
I need somebody that can pray in the anointing. Come on, somebody. I wish I had somebody here with me this morning. I need somebody that can preach in the anointing. Come on, somebody. I need somebody that will stand up as a bold soldier in the anointing. I need somebody that will raise their hand and say, Lord, for you I live, and for God I will die. I need somebody that will stand for the Lord in the anointing. Saul's servant, King Saul's servant. Amen. He says, hey, King, I know somebody. He is a lad, but I know somebody. He is the son, amen, of Jesse, a Benjamite. He is a mighty, violent man. Other words, he got some education. He knows how to talk. He knows when to talk. He knows what to say. And he knows how to say it. Can I get a witness in here? My grandmother used to tell me, son, it's not what you say, it's how you say it. Some phony hurt people's feelings, amen. Call themselves being good, but they tear somebody apart because of how you say it. Come on, somebody. It ain't what you say, it's how you say it. You can build somebody up, amen. But you can also tear them down with the same word, that three-letter word, I love you. If you say it sarcastically, then it tears them down. If you say it sexually, it will tear them down. But if you say it in the anointing, brother, my sister, you don't have to be that way. Love you, and guess what? Jesus,
come on.
Loves you too. When you, amen, begin, amen, your journey in the anointing, folks will recognize who you are. Come on, so I wish I could get a witness in here. You don't have to go around advertising. You don't have to wear a big robe. You don't have to wear a big cross. You don't have to call out and scream your title, because the title means nothing if you don't have the
anointing.
Somebody ought to recognize the anointing in you. Many of us wonder why folks don't want to hear you. Come on, somebody. It's the anointing. Some folks wonder why folks don't want to be bothered. It's the anointing. The Bible clearly says, amen, Apostle Carlos, come on, somebody. The word of God says, Apostle Parker, amen. The word of God says, amen, children, amen, of the gospel. The Holy Ghost cannot dwell in any unclean vessel. And if you don't have the Holy Ghost, tell me, somebody, how can you have the anointing? Oh, come on, somebody. Let me remind you, not only, amen, the Spirit knows the Spirit by the Spirit of God, amen, but guess what? The Spirit of the Spirit of Satan, he knows it too. Can I get a witness in here? I often tell folks, Satan don't mess with something he's already got. He knows the Spirit by the Spirit. Why? Because he was a spirit. But back to our text. He says, wait a minute. Come on now. Let me speak. Amen. He says, King Saul, behold, I have seen. That's the key word right there. He said, King Saul, I have seen. Not only have I heard, but I have. God Almighty. Not only King Saul have I heard to the grapevine, but I have with my own eyes, I have seen. I'm a living testimony. I am a witness to this young man. I am a witness to this young lady. I am a witness that they are anointed. They are called. They are chosen. They have the hand of God on them, and they will operate in the glory of the Lord. Call on them. And the Bible declares, after Saul said, heard these words from his servant, look at the text. In verse 17, it says, and Saul said unto his servants, provide me now a man that can play and bring him to me. Come on, somebody. Well, look at this. Let's go down a little bit farther. After the servant had been a testament after he had been a testament for Jesse's son David. And guess what? Look at the text. You see, David didn't know her. Jesse didn't know her. That the testament of his life had been spoken to the great king. Other words, David was in the field tending sheep. Y'all didn't hear me. Jesse, our son, lad David, he was in the field fending his father's sheep. He wasn't out there trying to make a name for himself. Can I get a witness in here? No. He wasn't boasting. He wasn't stuffed up. He wasn't proud, amen. He wasn't writing his name all over the walls throughout the city. He wasn't trying to elevate himself by putting other folks down. No, he was out there tending the sheep. Come on, somebody. In other words, when you, amen, allow the Holy Spirit, amen, to use you, you don't have to go out there, amen, and advertise yourself. No. When the Holy Spirit is on you, all you got to do is do what thus says the Lord, and God will set it up where folks will speak for him. Good God Almighty, yeah, speak for you. Oh, you don't have to do no advertisement. You ain't got to hold, I'm a prophet. I'm this. I'm that. I'm the other. I'm this, and that. I'm doctor. I'm apostle, bishop, prophet, teacher, and all of these things. I'm carrying all this on my shoulder. And guess what? When it comes down to it, honey, you ain't nothing but dirt and dust. For the dust you came from is the dust you're going to return to. So until you renounce that stuff and allow the Holy Spirit to use you, your title means nothing.
Jesus.
Grandmother.
Jesus.
Used to tell me, a fool recognizes a fool. Come on, somebody. And fools hang with fools. Crazy hang with crazy. Drunks hang with drunks. Drugs hangs with drugs. Prostitutes hangs with prostitutes. Johns hangs with Johns. Come on, somebody. But the rich hangs with the rich. Because the poor kicking with the poor. But the rich in glory.
Say so now.
The anointed hangs with the anointed. For the word of God says in the book of Proverbs, night and day cannot exist at the same.
Amen.
Well, I wish I had a Christian church in here. Can't receive at the same time. But back to our thing. Look at here. Amen. After Saul had put the decree out, servant began to testify, amen, unto the mighty, prudent matters of David, the land. Look at this. Verse 19, it says, wherefore Saul sent messengers unto Jesse and said, send me David, thy son, which is with the sheep. Look at that text. 1 Samuel 16 and 19. If you notice, when you begin, amen, to in this word, amen, you will notice after, amen, the servant, amen, told King Saul about David, amen, the King Saul never ever questioned the servant.
Come on now. Amen.
King Saul never inquired anymore about what his servant told him about David. Come on, somebody. King Saul didn't know David. Come on, somebody. King Saul, he never heard about David. Come on, somebody. All the king's men and a great few other never mentioned David, but there was one that says, wait a minute, King Saul, I know. Of this one that prays in the anointing. Look at this. So after King Saul listened to his servant, another son, understand, it wasn't none of his high priests. Come on, somebody. It wasn't the bishop that was talking to King Saul. It wasn't the minister of music that was talking to King Saul. It wasn't the handmaid. It wasn't the queen that was talking to King Saul. It was a servant. Good God Almighty. It was a servant that told King Saul about David. And King Saul, as big and mighty as he was, he didn't question the servant. He said, go and bring me. Other words, what the word of God is telling you, amen, that God will set it up with those that sit on high. Will come after you.
Amen.
They will come, amen, to inquire about you.
Yes.
When you allow God to use you with, you allow the anointing to saturate you. You don't have to speak. Your life will speak for. There's an old songwriter, amen, back in the 80s, amen, that wrote a song that says, may the life I live, come on somebody, speak for me. Ah, may the words that I speak, amen, speak for me. May the walk that I walk speak for me. May the love that I show speak for me. And the Bible declares that Saul sent after David. And David's name began to get famous. And there he is. All over the land. There he is right there. Just because somebody, a nobody, trying to tell everybody about somebody that loves the Lord, told King Saul about this little boy named David. And the king sent for David, and David began to perform before the king, and his name began to spread all over the land. That's what God has set up for you, you, and you. He said, all I want you to do is to serve me in spirit and in truth. All I want you to do is go tell somebody that I love them and I will spread your name all over this land. All I ask you to do is to go and preach my word and I will spread your name all over this land. All I ask is that you go where I tell you to go and do what I tell you to do and I will spread your name all over this land. And just as I told Abraham, so shall I give the promise unto you. They that bless you shall be blessed. And they that curse you, God Almighty, shall be cursed. I'm here to let you know that all God wants is for you to worship Him in spirit and in truth. To give your all unto the Lord, and He will cause you to be famous all over the world. As a songwriter says, nobody can do me, get God Almighty, like Jesus. Come on, let's give God some praise in this house. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. The doors of this church is open. Let us all stand together. Amen. The doors of this church is open. If you desire, amen, a church home, amen, we, amen, offer you two, amen, two churches in one, the House of Transformation Miracle Ministries here, amen, in Atlanta, Georgia, and the Fountain of Life, amen, in, amen, Charlotte, North Carolina, amen. God bless you. Amen. We here, amen, will want to spoil you with love. Amen. If you stand in the need of